what you say when you moan it out. Hallelujah. And we realize from whence the Lord has brought us. We realize that the saints of old went through some moaning things. Truly thou art my redeemer, more of thee and less of me. Empty pitcher before an ever-flowing fountain. Use me, Lord, in thy service. Strengthen me, Lord, and draw me closer, Lord, to thee. Speak, Lord, to this thy poor, weak, and earthen vessel. We shall be ever careful to give you the praise and the glory. For it's in the name of Jesus. Wonderful, mighty, marvelous, counselor. Prince of Peace, everlasting Father, all in all, Jesus. Lord, I call you, better I sound, feel. Jesus, in the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, every tongue should confess. Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 19. 2 Kings chapter 2. Verse 19, we honor God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. We thank God for all these great preachers, for our deacon and deaconess, and to our Levitical and music ministers, our youth, and to all who have assembled, set of men and women, boys and girls, should there be any. Today is a great day. Accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. There's just something about church, ain't there? There's something about church. I mean, ripping and running the last few weeks and tired and low down, but it's just something about church.
All right.
I understand now how the psalmist said, I almost had given up, but when I got to church, hallelujah. Church will lift you up. I tell folks all the time, they talk about, I'm going to stay at home because I'm sick. That's why you ought to come to church. I stay at home because I'm not fit. That's when you ought to come to church. Hallelujah. It's just something about it. The saints gathering together, praying and lifting up the name of Jesus, singing the songs of Zion. Hallelujah. 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 19. The men of the city said unto Elisha, behold, I pray thee, the situation of this city is pleasant, as the Lord seeth. But the water is naught, and the ground is barren. God's word for God's people. For a few minutes, we want to take you back and talk about the fact that the city is pleasant, but the water is bad. The city is pleasant, but the water is bad. The book of 2 Kings continues the drama begun in 1 Kings. The tragic history of two nations on a collision course with captivity. The author automatically traces the reigning monarch of Israel and Judah. First by carrying one forward and then coming and retracing the same period for the other nation. 19 consecutive evil kings rule in Israel, leading to the captivity by Assyria. The picture is somewhat brighter in Judah, where godly kings will occasionally emerge to reform the evils of their predecessors. In the end, however, sin outweighs righteousness, and Judah is marched off to Babylon. Yeah, the city is pleasant. The water is bad. Yeah, indicate the city being pleasant indicates that all looks good on the outside. is not. Some folks are like that. Look fine on the outside. Look okay. Look all right. But deep down, something wrong. The water is bad. Sadly, some families, some homes, are that way. They appear pleasant. Everything seems to be in order. They appear on the level. They appear steady and steadfast. But deep down, the water is bad. Sad to say, but even in some churches, look good, everything going well, fine structure, great organization, superb finances, excellent attendance, but deep down, the water is bad. Sad to say, it's pleasant as well as things look on the outside. The water was bad.
Yes, sir.
Understand that water, H2O, is the life force of all living things. Mm-hmm. Plants and animals must have water. It is necessary. Water descends from the clouds as rain, water, falling rivers, lakes, seas, ocean. Water is the standard for specific heat. Freezes at 32 degrees Fahrenheit or 0 Celsius. It boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit or 100 degrees Celsius. Water refreshes the spirit. Water enlivens the body. Oh yeah, yeah. Water nourishes the plant. Water helps them to grow. Water is essential in our lives. 70% of the earth's surface is water. Two-thirds of a human body is water. The blood of a human is primarily water. The sap in a plant is primarily water. Water, converted to steam, creates power that runs engines and other machines. Water is necessary. I tell you, you actually can do without food longer than you can do without water.
Yeah.
Water is necessary. Folks out in some third world countries have to walk for hours and some even for days just to get a gallon or two of fresh water. Yeah. When water dries up, crops dry up, animals die. Livelihood is gone because water is a necessity.
That's right.
Take a panoramic view of the city in the text today. I see a city that is pleasant, but the water is bad.
Yeah,
let me tell you something. I used to hear folks say, when you go to the city got hard water. I used to hear them say, take something, soften the water. Take something to clean the bathtub out because it'll leave a ring because you got hard water. But water is still necessary.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, the pleasant is pleasing, agreeable, gratifying, welcome, pleasurable, delightful, joyful. Hallelujah. Delectable. The city is pleasant. The city looks good. But the water is bad. The city has a lovely layout, rolling hills and sculpted streets and roads and arenas and avenues, but the water is bad. The dining facilities are pleasant, got all kind of restaurants, fast food places, anything you want, any way you want to eat is all laid out for you, but the water is bad. Shopping malls are scattered all over the city. Places to shop, name brand stores, get what you want, anything you want. It's available, it's there, it's pleasant, but the water is bad. To facilitate your travel, you got dealerships, car dealerships, you got bus. bus line, you got train line, you got taxi service, everything you want to get over and travel and transport yourself, but the water is bad. Need something. Petroleum, you got service station, gas station, whatever you want to call them, self-serve, full serve, everything is laid out, but still the water is bad. You're tired, you got motels, hotels, rooming houses, boarding houses, bread and breakfast houses. Everything is laid out for your comfort, but the water is bad. You think about settling in the city. There are educational places, schools, junior college, elementary, junior high, senior high, junior college. Yeah, you're right in the area. Plenty of educational facilities, but the water is bad. Oh yeah, you got a place for recreational there, name brand recreational facility. You can play golf, you can play tennis there, various softball, basketball, football, whatever your heart desires, you can play recreationally there, but the water is bad. Sunday morning, you got plenty of churches to go to. Spiritual churches, everything is lifted up, various denominations, whatever. You have an opportunity to worship, but the water is bad. We got a problem. The water is bad. When the water is bad, things wither. When the water is bad, things die. When the water is bad, things droop. When the water is bad, some bad water. All over this country. Oh yeah, some bad water. Single parent home, bad water. Abusive homes, bad water. Huh? Families being separated at the border, bad water. Addicted homes, bad water. Oh yeah, even in the school system, illiterate students, bad water. More dropouts, bad water. More teenage practicing, bad water. More children having children, bad water. Even in the communities, bad water. More break-in. You locked up the prisoners are locked on the outside. Bad water. More gang activity. Churches, more apathy, bad water, less commitment to, bad water, less trust in, less turning to, less concern for, bad water. Left out a crack bag yesterday, and a preacher stopped me and said, Pastor, you're going to be getting a phone call pretty soon. So I was sitting out there at Walmart, and I saw a couple out there, and they said they didn't have anywhere to stay, and they were looking for a preacher. This was a preacher talking to me. And he said to me, Pastor, I didn't say nothing, but the highway patrolman was looking in the phone book, trying to find your number so they could call you. I got home, phone rang. That was a preacher there. I got home, the phone rang, and a young lady got on the line, said to me, said, me and my husband, we're traveling, we've been walking, we're trying to find somewhere to stay tonight. We got to get up in the morning, we're trying to get up on the highway. Said, and Pastor so-and-so told us to call you.
Right. He's looking for a pastor. Thank you, Pastor.
And said, quite possibly, you could help us. Preacher sitting at the Walmart. Another preacher told him to call this preacher. Two preachers. Mm-hmm. An opportunity to help him. Mm-hmm. But they passed them over to this preacher. Ain't that something?
Yes, sir.
Ain't that something?
Amen.
I just sat there. First of all, when the first preacher said, I said, I didn't believe. And then when they called me and said, another noted pastor had told them to call this pastor. Hallelujah. Bad water. Bad water. When I gave the process, the procedure, they said to me, well, pastor, we'll call you back. I didn't hear no more from them. But I kept thinking over in the night, two preachers, two pastors had passed over to me when they had an opportunity to help them. They said, bad water. You care what you say. Bad water. Elisha, Elisha. Protagonist in our text, Elijah, who followed after Elijah. Yeah, Elisha, who took up the mantle. Elisha, who met the men from Jericho. Elisha, yeah, said to Elijah, yeah, the winter, the city is pleasant. He said, oh, yeah, it looks good. It's a city of fragrance because it has some fragrant fruit trees. It's a city of palm trees with gently wave in the breeze. A city on the Jordan, a seaport town, a city of beauty, rolling hills and level plain. But let me tell you, brother preacher, the water is bad. Yeah, water is killing off some folks. The water is bad. We don't know what to do. We don't know what to do. We don't know what the remedy is. And Elisha went to the river, took some salt, put it in the source of the water, and told him, said, come on, pull it out now and drink it. And they drank it. Everything was all right. Oh, yeah, I want to let you know, in America, in Mississippi, in Panola County, in Batesville, there is a remedy to bad water. There's a remedy to violence. There's a remedy to shooting folks. There's a remedy to killing folks. There's a remedy to abusive homes and relationships. There is a remedy. Hallelujah. God fixed that thing. God fixed it before the foundation of the world. Oh yeah, he took his only son, his only begotten son, and the Bible said before the foundation of the world, Jesus laid out the plan. Jesus laid out the foundation. Jesus fixed it that all might be saved. Oh yeah, man messed up in the Garden of Eden. Yeah, he ate wrongly. He did what was wrong. But thank God, God had fixed it. Yeah, he had put him outside the garden and put seraphim and angels at the gate and would not allow him to come back in the garden. But thank God, he had already laid out a plan. Yeah, he traveled man down through 42 generations. Oh yeah, let his son get off in Bethlehem. Laid him in an old manger and wrapped him Let it sit there, and after invite you to get to know the filtration. Ha ha.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Jesus is able. Clear you. From your sins be a scar. Jesus said, I'll wash you and make you white as your skin. Hallelujah. Ain't it amazing how a brown cow could eat green bread and give out white milk?